interesting collect today. It was written a long time ago, and it recalls the decay of the Western Empire during the 5th and 6th centuries as the barbarian migrations and settlements were taking place. And so I suppose in one respect, and at first glance, prayer might sound a bit anachronistic. However, that really may not be the case. You see, ours is a time of change also. And I'm not all that sure that the world is any more peaceably ordered now than it was even then. So, we've new barbarians, really, to deal with in our own day and age. Now, most admittedly, they wear different clothing, but they attack all that is good and godly and holy. The secularists, the godless who tout the supposed superiority of mere human intellect and achievement, while ignoring totally the spiritual, the presence of God, and at times they are even openly hostile to religion. And even in certain pockets of Mother Church, we have problems. There is neither joy nor solitude, rather conflict and cacophony. So, in other words, to quote the epistle, we are not all of one mind having compassion one of another. And so the human dilemma is not new. We all individually wrestle with our beliefs, and hopefully through the passage of time and the work of the Holy Spirit within us, we come to understand and more fully embrace the full truth of the gospel, and then we become God's mature people in Christ Jesus. And then that's when we, as His church, begin to joyfully serve Him in all godly quietness. However, having said that, many Christians are still, and this happens through the ages, still babes in Christ, just learning the faith. And so, in their ignorance, sometimes they choose their own truth instead of the gospel truth, the gospel message. Now, such a choice is much like what Pontius Pilate did. You remember this action with our Lord? He talked with Jesus, and he heard our Lord say, "To this end was I born. In this cause came I into the world, that I should bear witness unto the truth." And Pilate looked at him and said, "What is truth?" So, here's what we face. We live in a time in which many people think truth is relative. Now, here's an example. I've lost who said this, but he was a lawyer, and he said, "My search for truth led me nowhere. So, I became a lawyer where truth is relative." Truth is relative in the judicial system? How so? Set aside truth and justice and replace it with relativism? So the ideals can be replaced with egos? Then it's not to seek the truth, but to win? That may be acceptable for some lawyers. However, how about Christians? How do we come to the point of not only knowing, but embracing, living the truth of the gospel, so that we will do the things that we're called to do, that is to say, for example, those things in today's epistle? Well, the gospel narrative gives us some help. Only a few things happen in it. Jesus came into the presence of some fishermen, a fellow named Simon, Peter, and two brothers named James and John. Jesus was being pressed upon by the people, and so he got into Simon's boat and asked Simon to thrust out a little from the land. Simon did, and Jesus taught the people from the boat. Now, nothing much happened to those fellows during that time, at least that we know of, other than hearing our Lord teach the people. And so when he was done teaching, Jesus said to Peter, "Simon, launch out into the deep." Simon was hesitant, but finally he did it. And he witnessed a miracle. And he immediately both realized and declared his sinfulness with those powerful words, "Depart from me, for I am a sinful man." He knew that the holy had taken place. And so Jesus responded, "Fear not. From here on out you will catch men." And from that moment on, those fishermen were in the midst of being transformed and made finally and essentially into Christ's apostles, his soldiers who would serve him in holiness and righteousness all the days of their life. Two things speak to us powerfully. First, the transformation happened not when they simply thrust out a little from the land. That was part of the process, the first step, and the one, I suppose, that many Christians in our day have accomplished already. Just taking a step or two in the right direction. Kind of like when you're getting ready to jump into a swimming pool, and you stick your toe into the water to see how cold it is. That's what people do with the faith oftentimes. They try it out. You know, don't go whole hog. Just do a little bit and see how it feels. You don't get the truth that way. Thrusting out a little from the land didn't make those fishermen change. The extraordinary life became inevitable. However, with Simon's positive response to Jesus' command, launch out into the deep. That's number two. You see, we can have that same experience. Believe the words of Christ and live them no matter what fear you may have of being laughed at or ridiculed or misunderstood, whatever the doubts, the hesitancies. Embrace the truth of the cross of Christ. Don't ever worry about being placed in harm's way, because it doesn't matter. Believe it and live it in your life. Don't thrust out a little from the land, but launch out into the deep. Jump headfirst into the new life given by Christ, and do not be afraid. He will not let you drown. However, you will be immersed in His love. See you next week.